Welcome back, everyone. I am the Depressed Eeyore, and this is Sid Meier's Civilization 5. Let's see where we can go. We finished our war with Suleiman. We liberated two civilizations. So they're back. Gaja and Venice are back, finally. They're not really any threats, but all that work pretty much ensured that what friends I have will remain my friends. All right. Refuse. I have 24 wonders now because I just took a bunch back. If you look at our not demographics. Well, demographics, I'm pretty much topping everything. Let's look at global politics. Venice has Stonehenge and the Great Lighthouse, so I gave those up when I gave it back to him. But now I took everything except for those five there, which I believe were Gaja's. Syria and Sanuki are friends. I already have a spaceship factory though. That sucks. That's okay. Do that. That. All right, who's making gold? Start making boosters. Anyone else want to make boosters? How about you? All right. I think we only need three. Yep, only three. I could start building nukes, but I don't really see a point in doing that. I've already overwhelmed their culture. Go figure. So yeah, we're influential with Venice, Assyria. Ottomans is pretty much the only ones that are giving us issues. But yeah, even with what we have right now, we'll overwhelm Indonesia in 24 turns, but it's going to be 516 for Tanuki. So I don't. Culture victory is not really going to be a thing. No. Do that. Well, that'll give us more culture. They didn't really give us a bunch of. Well, it evened out this with Ottomans, but that's about it. All right. I didn't really take any policies that would bolster my tourism, so I shouldn't really expect much. Alright, Mamazo is now in the information era. Mamazo is plotting its everyone, but that's a Tanuki for you. If I want to, I could start building things like this medical lab and all All that nonsense. Or a solar plant. Why not? Well, like a solar plant and a medical lab, museum, stable. I'll keep you busy. You're doing your thing. You're doing your thing. What about you? Let's get you a solar plant, a medical lab. I'll keep you busy. You can have a medical lab after this. Medical lab. Opera house, that medical lab. I never upgraded that artillery that's up there. Ooh, the CN tower. I might be able to snatch that. All I need is a great engineer, which I can't afford. Okay, never mind. I wouldn't mind trying for it anyway. Who knows what'll happen. All right, sounds good. Oh, and for you, medical, solar plant. Go ahead and upgrade you to that. Upgrade you to a helicopter gunship. You can become bazookas. That should be everything. Yep. All right, cool. I don't think I have anything here. Destroyers, battleships. Okay. You're gonna repeal it? Neutral. Nay, yay. Neutral, yay. Unknown. All right. Yeah. All right, we got the science thing going. So yeah. Tell you what, purchase a medical lab and you can start working on that. As for you, CN Tower, let's see if you can get this in 9 turns before anyone else. 'Cause that'll be nice. See if I can get rid of nukes. You can have that and that. And then you can start working on that after that. So yeah, the banning of nuclear proliferation or whatever it's called is you can keep what nukes you have, so if I need to, I can just start building nukes before it ever gets passed. Wow, this fight's still going. And I got rid of that city finally. So yeah, if I really just wanted the win, well, one, I have to retake Venice. I would have to take this city, and then I would have to take Sada over here. Another great person. It is a great scientist. And that's not a great scientist, that is a caravan. Okay, I'm not sure where this thing came from. I really don't. I have no clue. How far along are they? 6% done, and I haven't contributed anything yet. Okay, makes sense. You should be doing that. Yes, you are. And you can work on that afterwards. And you're just gonna do whatever. And I'm no longer following. Oh wow, you finished fast. You finished a few turns ahead of me, in fact. Alright, well, that's good to know. I'm gonna go ahead and drop these and go for that. All right. Would have been nice to get the CN Tower, but that's okay. Sure. Sure. All right, so we're about to get the engine. Am I missing anything? Is that it? Is the engine all I have left? Victory progress. I'm missing the engine and a booster, which is on, should be en route, I thought. Oh, it's right there. So yeah, we're about to finish. Actually, I could finish a lot sooner. I could have finished 3 turns sooner. That's okay. Yeah, whatever. We're just gonna purchase these then instead. Done. All right, so in 2 turns, I can start building that and finish it. Oh, that's quite an offer. Thank you. Thank you. I don't even know where you came from. Automate. I'm guessing everything's been done. You've said this before. Whatever. Particle physics. There is literally nothing else for to do, so we're just gonna go straight for future tech. In the meantime, let's 8 turns. You have an unemployed citizen? Your population's so big. Your population is so big that you literally have no room for any more things. This is amazing. I've never seen something like this happen before. I never had so much population that I literally had no slots left. Part of that's probably because I didn't. Well, I have no idea what the cause is. Wow, that's impressive. And each of these are providing additional science, too. Eh, whatever. SS engine, 8 turns. We got this. Oh, you can finally build a hermitage, can you? Don't really care what you're doing. Who is my highest culture city? That doesn't tell me anything. Highest culture is actually them. Okie-dokie then. Oh, a sir. Go for a hermitage then. All right, we win in 7 turns. It's almost year 2000. Oh wow, we did not get top. Probably because I switched some stuff around. If I hadn't, I probably would have just barely won. That's okay. So yeah, they just got this for free. They get a mission control, highest contributor, plus one production from scientists, plus one from engineers. Yeah. Not that big of a deal. I mean, it would have been nice if we had it, but we don't need it. Ah, screw it. I'll just let them pick. All right. Now we have a great scientist. Now we have the internet. So that doubled my tourism output. So now we'll overwhelm them in 35 turns. So yeah. So that's the problem. Warfare is the easiest way, easiest and fastest way to win besides the Congress. Usually. All right, with all that done, I'm just gonna get wealth. Because you don't get the major tourism stuff till much later, but I guess you can get tourism pretty soon if you like really work on getting those great work slots and stuff like that. But you also need a lot of cities too, so it's just really kind of a mess. All right, so all that passed. It's not passed. That passed. With aesthetics, we could have gotten additional. We could have gone for cultural exchange. But that's okay. Okay. Make a proposal. I don't care. Question mark. Do you still have? Yeah, you still have that. There's really not much I need to worry about here. If we did that, they'll be angry. Okay. They'll be angry if I did that. All right, scholars and residents, we'll help out Venice. I don't care. I don't even worry about crafting anything anymore. Yeah, whatever. And globalization is going to give us even more delegates. And we're about to have giant robots. Yeah, looking at this, I mean, you get double tourism at internet. You don't get National Visitor Center till telecommunications. I mean, you would have to build a lot of cities, all of them having great works, essentially, to make this work. And so, but I suppose if you spam a lot of archaeologists, you might be able to do something with that. I don't know. Not sure what to think of it. There's also those hidden antiquity sites, which are supposedly important as well, so I don't know. I'm not really much for mass expansion, because if you're expanding a lot, then you're also going to be at war anyway. But I mean, honestly, this went pretty well. Yeah, I've overwhelmed you. If it weren't for the fact that the Ottomans took over Venice rather early, as well as, everywhere else, we probably could have done a culture victory pretty easily. Mamazo wasn't too. I mean, she's a threat. She had her own continent and was kind of just hanging around and, winning, essentially. But since we're allies with her, she didn't really do anything to us. The biggest issue was just trying to get land here. I wasn't planning on doing any warfare. I was planning on just, growing and just minding my own business, but Marissa settled so close to me that I would just be choked out completely. And Marissa ended up being rather difficult because of her mushroom patches that do damage, like many citadels. And she also had the Great Wall. And I tried to not, like, go around just taking over everything, but Marissa was just literally a thorn in my side the entire time, because Sohnhelm here blocked my way to attacking Maria whenever she attacked me. I got attacked a lot, actually. Maria declared war on me like two, three times. Ottomans declared, me like maybe an additional time, and I really just went after Assyria just because, with how fast they grow in this difficulty. I almost feel like I almost have to take over a few cities, especially capitals, in order to keep up, but I don't know. I don't think it's that bad, but taking over a capital is definitely a huge bonus. And as long as you don't go overboard with it, most people won't care, which is pretty nice. But yeah, I at least kept my promise and kept Assyria alive. I left them alone. Maria just was such a pain. And so was Marissa, unfortunately. Anyway, let's enough rambling. As for the faction itself, it's not bad. If we take a quick look. Yeah, plus one food for all pastures, plus one plantation, plus one gold for every plantation, and you get a free worker for every water mill you have, which is actually rather nice because I always hate going through the trouble of building a worker. The special unit is all right. It's a scout crossbowman, essentially. And then the special building was pretty important because it gives you extra gold. Gives you extra gold for every bonus resource, which is pretty good. So yeah, I think it's a pretty fun little faction. It doesn't seem too ridiculous. It's definitely one you can play passively if you're left alone. Yeah, and it's a civilization that really favors rivers, because rivers give you access to watermills. So, let's end this, shall we? And we won. Year 2004. Go Beyond Earth. I haven't played Beyond Earth. I heard it wasn't as great. So maybe I'll get better once I get more expansions and stuff like that, but I don't know. I'll be sticking with this for now. So yeah, that was Negin No Soto, or the Human Village, led by Keen. So yeah, good faction, pretty fun. It was a very interesting battle getting through this climb. We started out pretty far behind and gradually climbed our way to the top, which is a lot of fun. Also, we had a lot of warfare, especially naval warfare. It took effort to do what I did. So, and also I've been gradually warming up to cavalry. Cavalry with their ability to move four spaces. Yeah, they're usually not good for attacking cities, but as long as you weaken them with artillery, you can just use them to quickly swoop in and take the win. So, I don't know what we'll be going for next. Not sure even what sort of victory I'll go for. Probably just at this point I'll just go with whatever. So, I am Theodoprest Eeyore, and this was Sid Meier's Civilization V as Keen with a science victory. See you guys later.